So the growth of the plant is what gives rise to the Fibonacci pattern. So how does that work? Okay, here's a model. It's a model of the shoot of a growing plant. You think of this as a very, very tiny shoot. Just come up out of the ground. This is enormously magnified. And it's growing. And as it grows, these little blobs appear. And those are called primordia. Those are what are going to turn into all the interesting bits and pieces of the plant. The petals, the seeds, everything. And they pop into existence one by one. When it first starts, there are none of them. Then you see one, then another one, then another one, then another one. And they appear near the middle and they move outwards to get this sort of pattern. Looks a bit like a pizza. In fact, Leonardo's nickname ought not to be Fibonacci. It ought to be Leonardo of Pizza. Suppose we slice across this growing shoot. What we find inside is the spiral pattern, the same spiral pattern. Now, the question is, what is it that makes that pattern work? And there were two French scientists, Auguste and Louis Bravais. They were crystallographers. If you're a crystallographer, what do? You measure angles. And the Bravais brothers discovered this whole pattern is governed by one special angle. And again, I need a volunteer from the audience. Okay, you want to come help me measure the angles and see what's going on here. Okay, here's your protractor. Got a protractor to measure. And let's just move it around this way. What you have to do is you have to know that when these primordia appear, they start in the middle and they move somewhere. And the first one to appear ends up here. Second one's over there, a long way away. Third one's over here. Fourth one's over there. They seem to be all over the place. Now, what I want you to do is to measure the angle between the first one, the middle, and the second one. So, yeah, let's pop it down. Okay. We'll fit that end on the second one, and let's see what angle we get around here. Okay. And what do you make that?
I mean, 140 degrees.
Right. Great. What's your name, by the way?
Marcus.
Okay, Marcus. Thanks. Now, what about the angle between number 2 and 3? Can you just move it round and compare? Just sort of turn it that way. That's it. And let's see how the angle between number 2 and 3 compares with the angle that we had. Okay, we want to go to the middle here. And we want to... Oh, we'll put it there. Oh, look. What do we notice? It fits again, doesn't it? So it seems 140 degrees again. And what about the angle between 3 and 4? You want to slide it round and we'll check that one. Okay. Let's come on round. In between... Okay, 3 and 4. Gosh. That's 140 degrees as well. Okay, now don't go away. I need you for a lot more yet. What we've discovered is this special angle of about 140 degrees. You want to hold that for a minute and perhaps come around here. That's it. What the Bravais brothers found was it doesn't matter which two primordia you take. If you take a primordium and the next one that follows it, and you look to where they go and then you measure the angle, you always get the same number. And the answer they got is 137.5 degrees. So your 140 is extremely close. And what we've got to do is find out the significance of that special 137.5 degree angle. Okay. So, what has that angle got to do with Fibonacci numbers and the sunflower spirals? What I've got here is a couple of pies. And look at this one. We've cut the circle into 8 equal pieces. Equal slices, 8, that's a Fibonacci number. And the previous Fibonacci number is 5. So what I've got to do is take away 5 of those 8. We'll get rid of those. Now, Marcus, you're the custodian of the angle. Can just compare it with that angle there. Let's have a look. Yeah, you want to lean over? That's super. It's pretty close. And in fact, if we use the Bravais brothers' angle, which is about here, is even closer. Okay? So 3/8 of Fibonacci fraction of a circle is very, very close to 137.5 degrees. In fact, that's 135 degrees. It's only 2.5 wrong. What about this one? Okay, now here we've got 13 slices. That's the next Fibonacci number. And I'm throwing away 8. So 5 are left. 5, 8, 13. Let's compare that angle. That's amazingly close as well. Look at that. It's almost exact. In fact, this is 138.4 degrees. It's almost a degree bigger. Okay, so we've got an angle that's slightly too small, an angle that's slightly too big, both related to Fibonacci numbers, and the 137.5 degree angle in the middle. And if you use bigger and bigger and bigger Fibonacci numbers and form fractions from them, you get angles which sandwich in on the angle the Bravais brothers measured. It's called the golden angle, very special, and it's the one defined by this process with Fibonacci numbers. Now, we haven't finished yet, though. I'm going to give you the wrong angle, and I'm going to ask you to make us a sunflower seed head using the wrong angle and see what we get. So you want to come around here, that's it. What I want you to do, we're going to put in the primordia, and to save time, instead of putting them in the middle and moving them to the edge, we'll just put them at the edge where they end up. And suppose we used an angle of 135 degrees to put them in, what pattern are we going to get? Okay, so do you want to use that to measure? And let's see where the next one goes. I guess, okay, so over there, it's going to be there, is it? Okay, so I'll put that one there. Now, perhaps you want to put them in. So the next one would be there. Great. And then the next one after that is going to be over there. And then, next one after that. Oh, that's interesting. I'll do that. That's over there. And the next one after that. Here we go. Where's that go? It goes there. And then you have that. After that comes one over there. And now one over here. Okay. And then where would it go after that? Oh, here we go. That's it. Well, you want it there. It would go sort of inside it there. And what you notice is it's always going to be on one of these lines. Because what are we doing? We're using 3 slices of the pie to measure it. So it always just moves around 3. Yeah. And if we kept on doing this, it's going to move around like this, and like that, and like that, and like that. And I won't bother putting any more in. You're beginning to see what will happen. OK, Marcus, thanks a lot. That's great. Thank you. So what we're getting here is a pattern of 8 spokes. Would that make a good sunflower seed head? No. It wouldn't. Why wouldn't it? Because it's got big gaps in it. It would fall to bits. It would break apart. It wouldn't make this nice, compact, circular seed head. It's got a Fibonacci number of spokes, but they're spokes. Now, the same sort of thing would happen if we used this one with its 13 radial lines. If I were to use this angle to make the seed head, what I would get would be 13 straight spokes. So what we're seeing here is there's an angle that's a bit too small. There's the correct angle, the golden angle. And there's an angle that's a little bit too big. Neither of those make good sunflower heads, but they do make patterns with Fibonacci numbers in them. But instead of spirals, they're straight. So now what I'm going to do is show you what happens if we start with this angle, small one, 8 spokes, and move slowly, change that angle, and keep building different sunflower seed heads, pass through the golden angle in the middle, and see what happens when we get there. and then move on a little bit to this angle, 5/13 of a circle, where we will get 13 spokes. Now, to do that, we're going to put that on a computer. The computer's over here, and if you just bear with me for a moment, I'll have to adjust this so that we get just the right angle for the camera to see it. That's about it. Okay, so what we see there is the 8 spokes that comes from that slightly smaller angle, 135 degrees. I'm going to change that angle half a degree at a time, and I want you to watch what happens. So if we go to 135.5, what we see now is still 8 spokes, but they're curving. They're starting to look a bit like those spirals. Why are they curving? Because it misses by half a degree every time, and so it bends. And if we go up again, another half a degree, they bend more. That's 136 degrees. 136.5. It's still not making a good sunflower head. There are gaps in it. 137. Still quite big gaps. Up comes the golden angle, 137.5. And there we see beautiful patterns, and they all fit together. It looks exactly like the sunflower spirals. So that's the angle at which it all packs together perfectly. And because these things are very close to Fibonacci fractions, we see all these Fibonacci numbers.